Hello everyone, welcome back to another ETS2 video. In this one we're going to have a look at the DAF F241 made by XBS. Last time we looked at the DAF 95 ATI made by XBS, I believe. And we've also had a look at the Scania RJL, which you can find on Steam with this mod. I'll leave a link in the description so you'll be able to access it for yourself if you like. Before we go any further, I'd like to ask if you could leave any comments or suggestions below so I can improve on my videos. And thank you very much for watching. Let's get into it, have a look at this mod. So I've noticed that the mod, we're currently at the DAF truck dealership in Bremen, and each cab style has a slot at the start, I guess you'd call it a slot, so you can choose your cabin style here, but even in each one of these, and changes the chassis as well. But once you go into even the basic one, the day cab, and if we go into custom configuration, we can still change the cab. We will go with the space cab. And just to let you know, I don't have any other mods running at the moment. So if you had like a Sissel mega pack or an accessory mega pack, you should be able to get more accessories, which I'll show you. I've only got the truck running because I only want to be reviewing the truck. So we'll go on to chassis now. It's got the standard 4x2, the 6x2 tag lift at the rear, the 6x2 twin steer, so does the front axle at the rear and the normal steering axle, and then the 6x4 with the two driving axles at the rear, and that's the one we'll go with because the 6x4 is my favourite. In here we have a wide variety of engines, going from a measly 209 horsepower up to the 373 horsepower, so not really that great in the horsepower. We'll stick with a 250, I guess. That's the original one. Transmission is only the five different ones there. ZF, which is a automatic transmission. They're all automatic ZF. I'm guessing that's an Eaton Fuller, which would mean that should be a manual transmission. I dare say this truck would have came out with a 13 speed usually. The 13 speed interior, we have a standard brown. Have a look at the others. Changes, that's the dark exclusive brown and the exclusive dark. We will go this exclusive brown, I think. But I just want to check if we change the cabin, if the sleeper changes and this space cab up the top changes. So if we go the top sleeper, and then we go back to the interior, very good detail by them, XBS, to do that. And this one shouldn't have the cupboards and stuff up at the top, which it doesn't. So we'll go to space cab. In the exclusive brown. Moving on to colours, you've got a yellow, celestial blue, gunmetal blue, Milano red, polar white, your metallic or your custom metallic. Sorry. We'll see if that works. First colour. It's good. Second colour is good. And the third colour is good. You can see it changing colours up in this top corner here. A skin, an ATI skin, another ATI skin. That's a nice looking skin. I'm not sure, but I would say that there's other skins out there. And then it goes into your normal ETS2 skins there, if you want them. I think we might try a custom metallic, even if it's, didn't stay on that one. Blue maybe. Grey. Looks good from that angle. I will keep that. It's very basic. I'll keep that. And moving on to the accessories. Our lower grill. Got like a step at the bottom there, putting a bumper on the bottom if you want. I'll see what this one bumper is, stock steel, stock paint. We'll keep that bumper there. They call that a lower grill, that's probably more like a lower grill guard, that's probably more like a bumper to me. Intake lights, stock, paint plastic, all the paint all the way around the lights. Paint middle, no, all the stock. If we want to put the badge on it. Front mask or paint, no, stock, DAF, new DAF logo, old DAF, we have a new one, deflector, it's on the sides, is it? I don't know why it doesn't have them out further, but still a good addition there. Oh, that's the colour, I like the black ones better. That's inside our cabin. Sun visors, if you want one. I'm not a big fan of sun visors. Light bar. Attachment points, so we can put our lights on there. Horns. As you can see, I've only got the basic ones running. So we'll just put two radiant lights on at the moment. There's some further lights that we can put on, I'd say. Yeah. Even the touches are actually right on the side there. It's done well. Air conditioning on top. To blend it in, nice. No spoiler. I tried to see our little wings on the back there. I'm not 100% sure if they improve aerodynamics, but I dare say they would. It would mean that there wouldn't be as much air get caught in between the trailer and the cabin. That's my theory anyway. We'll keep the we'll paint the steps. We'll bring out and put some chrome on the doors. Door handles. Pity you can't see the actual door handles. You can't really see the door handles to see what they look like. We didn't do mirrors. What do they look like? We'll keep on plastic, I think. Wheels, because we only got the steering wheels on. We'll keep them. Mud guard at the front. We'll paint. Paints our front mud guard on the steering axle there. Air intake, which should come up the back. That'd, if that was a, not a space cab, or if it was a day cab or the sleeper cab, that should just stick over the top. Looks pretty nice there. Exhaust. Change it. Tank. Stock steel, stock paint, stock black. Stock steel. Oh, that's like a little catwalk up over our air tanks onto the back there. Wheels again and rims. And now our mud guards at the back. It'd be nice if we could choose if we wanted to paint them. It seems like we can't. And rear mud guards. We'll go with the new DAF logo ones here. Actually, it doesn't look too bad. Or the pretty poor colour at the front. Anyway, we'll go on to the inside. Driver's plate, steering wheel, so if you had a steering wheel pack you could adjust that. Because I don't have any of these running. And the navigator, if you had Sizzle's mega pack, if you wanted to put your dots on. Windscreen and hang your flags. You should be able to. Your little minions or whatever. Oh, I do have Sizzle's mega pack running, do I? Ooh. I was almost certain that I don't have it running. Maybe some of it's supporting that. Some of it's not. Sun visor on the outside. Hanging items. Driver's plate. I'm gonna have to have a look into that. Sorry about that. Side mirror if you want one. Don't know why you can't do that from the outside. Driver's seat if you want, dash plots on, so if you want to put coffee, see these ones aren't Sizzle's, so I don't know why that first one came up with Sizzle's. Weekend bag, and that's it. That's what it'll look like. not too bad of a truck. It's an old truck. Considering how quickly we put it together, it doesn't look too bad, but the mod definitely looks pretty good. You'll have a lot more time than I do in having a YouTube video to have a play around with it. You'll have all the different mods running properly, and be able to make a better truck, I would say. We'll confirm that and trade our other old truck in. See how long it load, takes the load. Not too bad. See if there's any big holes. Actually looks pretty nice. Instead of that. No big holes. Very good detail. Very shiny. Got the reflections going well. Shadowing's pretty good on it. See the metallic through it. Engine looks a bit old in there. Let's see how it runs. Ooh. Let's see if the lights work. Parkers and our lights, indicator, our oversized load lights work, reverse, and our brake lights work. I'll go for a quick drive. Does that move? Yeah, it does move the actual lever. Moves the lever when we indicate in the right direction. Sounds like a very old truck, which it is. If I was going to do this in like a drive it around, I'd probably paint it to match that it is an old truck. But other than that, it drives very well. I'll be driving this truck definitely in the future, taking my time to do a better, make it a lot better, have a few different mods so I can enjoy it a bit better. I guess that we're coming up to the end of the video and we have to give it a rating out of 5 rubber trucks, and I will give it 4. It's a hard one. I think I'll give it 4.5. It's, I don't know. Yeah, 4.5. Because it is a very good truck to drive. Maybe if we could get a bit more of a powerful engine, a more modern engine in it, would be nice if we could upgrade it just to get a modern engine in. But other than that, this is drives perfectly. It'd be a lot of fun to drive, I would say. Yes. Very nice truck. That brings us to the end of our video, and I would like to thank you for watching. As I said before earlier in the video, if you've got any suggestions, please leave them in the comments. Other than that, we'll see you next time. Thanks.